Alright, we've got a lot of playables going into this pack, so hopefully we just pick up some quality cards. And yep, I think it's time to let Feast of Blood go by the wayside, and because I'm going to go ahead and take the Survivalist here. I think even if I don't pick up 20 more allies, I already have a Cell Sword, and it's just, you know, a solid card. Wish I'd taken the first one over to Hexmage, but, you know, what's done is done. Might wheel it to Druid Archer, that's certainly a possibility, although this pack's probably not good enough for that to happen. There's a Kazul Warlord and a Umar Raptor, my allies deck. So now we have to decide between Ornn Reef Recluse and Suricar Marauder. Which is interesting. They're both pretty good. I think I don't have enough 2-drops yet, and with the 2 giant scorpions and 2 Heartstabbers, I'm pretty good on defense, so just go ahead and take the Marauder. Man, it's a, someone's getting a nice Living Tsunami 3rd or 4th. Gonna go ahead and take the Cell Sword, I don't think. I mean, I think you'd rather, until you have a ton of allies, Cell Sword's gonna be better than Diabolist, and I don't need another 6-drop. Alright. Predatory Urge has gotten a little better in this deck, but I still am not a huge fan. Soulstar Expedition's pretty good with all these Heartstabbers. I just don't see this as being a Vampire Last Rider deck. Because, I mean, Feast of Blood's not going to happen, so. At this point, I think I'd rather take the Soulstar. I think that's going to work better in this deck. I'm not playing any of these cards except possibly Goldra's Vampire. I do like Gigantiform Goldra's Vampire, though. You smash him for 8, which generally puts him to 10, then becomes a 10-9 fear, you know, trample guy, and yeah, that ends up working out pretty well. I mean, I know Gigantiform's awesome on anything, but he's particularly awesome on Goldra's Vampire. Geez, someone's got like a boatload of Umara Raptors. I don't know if I really want to play 2 Soulstar Expeditions, but I'm not playing Needlebite Trap or Colony Heart Expeditions, so. If I play against an attrition deck, I could side it in. There's a lot of Timbermaw Larvas. The old Timbermaw Larva Crypt Ripper deck. Alright. Yeah, I'm not playing Grim Discovery, even with my Harrow. That could be kind of annoying against me. Sure, Vastwood Gorger. I'm not playing Colony Heart Expedition, but I will take it anyway. Black ended up pretty disappointing, despite getting a 3rd pick Marsh Casualties in pack 1, with Hideous End still in the pack. Just wasn't a whole lot of black cards. So, green ended up being okay, but we've got a lot of cuts we need to make here. Although it's not going to be too hard to cut all these cards. Certainly a lot of creatures in this deck. Alright. Doesn't look like we're getting anything else from this pack, I would imagine. Although, you know, the 5 cents that each of these full art lands are worth, possibly. Alright. Alright, so we have a minor ally theme. Man, our deck would be a lot better if we took that Survivalist over to Hexmage. Oh well. One of these. And both of those. Heartstabbers cost kind of 7, hopefully. Alright, so that's where I'm going to start with. Then I've got Ghouldra's Vampire, 2nd Soulstair, Vampire's Bite, although I think that's worse than Primabella or Vines. Crypt Ripper, Vampire Hexmage, Vastwood Gorger. think one of the slots is going to be taken up by a Bastard Gorger. So let's see, what sort of mana base we're going to be running here. It looks probably something like 10 forests, 8 swamps. Yeah, with 8 swamps, I think Vampire Hexmage is still castable. I mean, probably better than like a random Ghoul Draws Vampire with not quite enough backup. And Vampire Hexmage is good with all these giant growth effects. And I guess it's okay with Gigantiform. Anything's good with Gigantiform. Although Gigantiform is pretty sweet in this deck. I've got Landfall Guy, which is, you know, evasion plus 2 plus 2. I've got these larvas, which get bigger. These cell swords and the survivalists that have counters. All my guys work pretty well with it. Yeah, I think Hexmage is a reasonable call here. Nine. I still would rather have 10-8. And I don't really have any one drops but the Solstice Expedition. I could play Piranha Marshes. Although, I think the risk is probably not worth it here. If I had the Ghoul Draws Vampires in, I'd probably play it, because Piranha Marshing then from 11 to 10 is always a beating. But as is, I don't think that's necessary. And especially when you have 2 Heartstabbers in your deck, wanting to draw your 7 land and having it be a Piranha Marsh is quite a dagger. So, and that is our deck.